Hello and welcome to this new video. Today I'm going to introduce a few concepts before getting to the point. How can we build flying saucers in KSP? First, let's talk about what I mean by flying saucers. To me, they are circular, have a general flattened shape, long landing legs and often multiple lights highlighting their shape. Flying saucers are a meme in science fiction. We can find numerous examples in TV shows or movies. The design had become quite popular in the 60s and 70s and was adapted for large buildings but also for residential homes. In particular, the Futuro houses by Finnish architect Matti Suuronen are so numerous that a special website has collected locations where we can still find them today. Now we have to have a talk about the mods I use. The only purpose I'm using add-ons is to favor the design I want to achieve. Extra technologies which are not brought by the stock games are not welcome here. No nuclear reactor, no gravity hack, no warp, no magical technology will be used. We have to succeed with chemical, nuclear or xenon engines. Tuck scale is almost mandatory in the process of building a flying saucer, except with the fraying method, but that will be the last video on this subject as it is the most difficult way to get something elegant. Tuck scale is a wonderful add-on which allows precise parts. It is highly useful for fuel tons, structural parts, and is most efficient for engines with setting the exact amount of thrust you want regarding the gravity of a specific celestial body. Thus, tweak scale is a must-have to optimize delta V. Restock is an add-on I have been converted to for more than a year now and considerably enhances the visual quality of stock parts. You can easily see with these comparisons how the user experience considerably improves. Restock Plus is a natural continuation of the stock game with providing missing parts while being very respectful of the original concepts. Nebula Decals is a nice mod which allows to personalize your planes, ships or stations. Decals can be additional flags or anything you like, as long as you know how to make PNG files with a transparent background. Near Future Solar allows me to bring more variety to solar panels as the stock ones are limited and Restock Plus does not provide much regarding energy support. Come on, aren't these solar panels beautiful? Case for Kerbal attachment system is a mod I use mostly to provide an elegant way to transfer fuel from one ship to another. It spares the use of grabbing units, which are not very logical to me. Thus, Case is not a mod I use on a daily basis. For my crafts, I will use several Restock Plus parts. It turns out that Restock Plus is not supported by Tweak Scale, so no Restock Plus parts can be resized. As it was a limit to me and for what I wanted to achieve, I have developed a plugin, a CFG file, which enables this support. The link is in the description. I have also developed a Tweak Scale config file for near solar future parts. I am not sure yet whether it will be used in this building guide or not, but you will also find it in the link provided. Although I'm pretty confident for the Restock Plus plugin, as I have tested it in multiple crafts and saves, use the Near Solar Future one at your own risks with the disposable KSP installation. Part clipping is always a delicate subject, and be aware that what I am going to say is for me, myself, and shall not be interpreted as a guidance for anybody. First rule, any structural part can collide with any other part. Rule 2. No fuel tank will be partly placed inside another fuel tank. No pod will be placed over another pod or tank, there must be room for cables. fuel tanks can be emptied and disabled on purpose to become structural parts. This is what I used for my KSS catfish, for example. Rule 3. Rule 2 may be amended in very specific cases, such as unused room is available in a specific volume, but the available parts provided by the game or your add-ons have not the appropriate shape to fill this room. Now let's talk about how we are going to build our flying saucers. Advanced tweakables are provided by the stock game and allow to auto-stress parts and choose whether you want a rigid attachment or not. It is one of the most popular tricks to avoid the wobble. Sub-assemblies are very useful to add a radial attachment to parts, especially for control pods. We can build such sub-parts with a cubic strut or a radial attachment point. Parts we want to be radially attached are lander can, science lab, crew cabin, and hitchhiker storage containers. Then, for some ships, we will need the 12 symmetry technique. The game allows to place parts with a 2, 4, 6, 8 symmetry, but it is possible to simulate a 12 symmetry with a double 6-1. To do so, put in place your 6 first parts, starting at a given quarter, then move to a next quarter to place the remaining 6 ones. To make a conclusion of this video, let's end with the 4 methods I have identified so far to make the external shape of flying saucers. We have first the adapter method, the fuel tank method, the heat shield method, and the fairing method. Each method will be reviewed in a specific video, so stay tuned. See you, and don't forget to test his adopt. Like, subscribe, comment.